Okay, so as some of you, I just bought a house in 2023, which is in a bougie-ass neighborhood. It's great. I love it. We mow our grass on the same days. I got to pick up my dog's dog poop. It's fun. Now, one of the things that happened this winter season is that we have what's called a home holiday walkthrough. Stay with me here. People will pay to come inside of my house and walk through and see my Christmas decorations, check in my house and ask me things like, hey, how are you? What do you do for a living, right? Now, as somebody who didn't grow around this stuff, it's weird. But as one of three melanated people in this neighborhood, it's pretty amazing. So I was like, yeah, sign me up. Now, the organizer of this was like, cool, here are a stack of tickets. Go ahead and, like a kid selling those coupon books, they were like, tickets are $10, hand them out to people, get the cash, and then good to go. There are five houses on this trip. Customers hold on to their tickets and they just go to each house. And this is why you don't bring people like me in the neighborhood, because immediately I was like, wait a minute. What's stopping me from saying I sold four tickets when in actuality I sold 20 and then I just had to come up? I just pocketed all that cash. We're not turning in the tickets or anybody's really presenting them for that matter. So I knew there has to be a better way. What would it look like if we brought this up to modern times where you could trust but verify? So I was like, you know what? Let me do something where like a customer can come over here and then buy a ticket on my web app, put it in their little shopping cart, check out with Stripe. And then a webhook is going to fire off an API, which is going to do three steps. Put an order inside of a database. And then this is where it gets cool. It is going to take an image template, put their name on it, as well as a barcode that can be scanned. And then we're going to use a Twilio API to send that customer the fully complete ticket that they purchase. And then I can use a front-end application after I've logged in to hit up an API and then redeem that ticket once they get to my door. This is amazing. I just want to focus on this piece right here, though. All right, so to kick things off, I'm going to be over here in Canva. I just searched something like holiday ticket, whatever, and this is what popped up. Now, this is close, but it's not quite what we want. So I modified some things. I updated the text. I removed the sample barcode. We're going to be inserting our own. I cleaned things up. What that means is that I ended up coming up with something that looks more like this right here. We have home, holiday walkthrough, some blank space. And then now I can really mess around with this. But one thing to note is that when I downloaded this and you go to share, and you want to make sure that when you download it, you do select PNG. And for me, I upped the resolution. Feel free to do this if you like, just so that it's a little bit crisper around the edges there. Once you have that downloaded locally on your computer, I opened it up in Figma. Now, what's really cool about Figma is that you have this idea of a ruler. So I can turn this on and off by using Shift R. And it's super, super helpful because we're going to need the dimensions of where we want to start putting this text. Now, if Shift R isn't working, you can always go to View and then turn on the ruler yourself right there. But from here, I just adjusted the ruler. I'm saying if the person buying this ticket is going to have their name on here, I want their name to be pretty much like right here, lined up with this, down a little bit, somewhere in there. You can see the X and the Y coordinates on the side. When it comes over to my barcode or my QR code, I want to support both options. I'm going to line that up somewhere around here. You can mess with these values as we're going to be creating these tickets, but it's super, super helpful to have a tool that allows you to do just that. Now, once you get a sense of where you want those dimensions to be, now we can open up our code editor. So I went ahead and I created a brand new project for my terminal. Three essential commands here. We have our index.mjs. Note that this isn't TypeScript. This isn't JavaScript. It's MJS. This is because I want to use import export on the server side with Node. So I could do things like import file from whatever, as opposed to something like const and then having a require statements inside of there. Cool. When it comes to our package.json, I just did npm init and just gave me the base repo that we can get set up with. And then of course I have my sample right here. And notice I named it Christmas sample ticket highres.png. Name yours whatever you want. You just want to adjust it accordingly as we start to build this out. Now, when it comes to the packages that we're going to need, there are, what are there? One, two packages. The first one is going to be Sharp. We're going to be using the Sharp library to get this taken care of. This is great for image manipulation and it's super, super fast. The other one is called BWIP.js. I hope I'm saying that. I'm probably butchering it. And then the last one is going to be text to SVG. What these two packages do are give us the ability to have images turned into buffers. So that way we can manipulate them for Stripe. Stripe is really great at having image buffers and manipulating them and composing them and all that good stuff. but we have to have a way to convert those images to buffers of text. Cool. Now we have that in place. The other thing is that I'm going to give my events some organization. So I'm going to say there's going to be an output inside of here. Inside of the output, there's going to be an event. And then inside of the event, we can have something like our holiday walkthrough. Now, when it comes to actually using these packages, we can go ahead and use our import syntax to bring in the files and packages that we need. So we have Sharp, of course. We're going to import path so that way we can reference certain directories. We have whip, and then we have file URL to path in addition to the text to SVG. Now, the reason why we need that file URL to path is because when you are working in a .mjs file, you don't have access to this handy underscore dir name. This is a really nice node utility that gives you the ability to reference your current working directory very easily. No worries though, we construct it just like that. And now we can go ahead and start putting in our functionality. So the first thing that we're gonna do is have our text turned into an SVG. This is gonna be the text that we want to show up as the user's name. Nothing too crazy from there. So what we can do is have a function called generate SVG. We can use it just, this is gonna take in the text that we wanna generate. And then as you see here, we're just gonna give it a color, turn it into a buffer, and then return that to the user. Now we also want methods to be able to generate a barcode and or a QR code, depending on what kind of application you're building. What I'll say is that a barcode is really nice. It looks cool on a ticket. And this is how you do it using that whip library. The problem with a barcode that I found is that if you have a service send it to you, then it'll get distorted. Essentially, a lot of services compress images, so barcodes are hard to show up. So just for the sake of completeness, I have the ability to generate a QR code as well. It's same library. We can still have it and just pass in QR code as the part that we want to use, but nothing too crazy going on from here. I did end up scaling it just because the default is small. But these are the three functions that we're going to end up having. The next one I'm going to create is just sort of the ability to create a ticket. So we'll put all of these together. I'm going to say async function and call this create ticket. And note that I am passing in the customer name, ticket ID, and the output of where we want to just store this thing. Now from here, I do want to set up sort of the ticket template path. And this is where that handy underscore dir name comes into place. It's going to take in the root of our directory and then find this image that we have right over here, right? Our ticket template. So we're going to assign that. And this is pretty much going to be our base image. We can do whatever manipulations from Sharp that we want to do from here. But really, all we want to do at this point is stick with that base image and just slap additional images on top of it. So I'm going to have a try catch. And inside of here, we can sort of get things set up to how we like. So in each of these, we're going to have the ability to call those generate functions. And each one is going to be represented as a buffer. So I'll throw those in here just like that, where we can generate a barcode, the customer's name from their text, and then the QR code image themselves. Nothing too crazy going on from there. Now, just to get rid of this error, I am going to have a catch block sitting right here. It's prettier to get rid of these red squigglies. All right. So now we're generating these. And if I look at the type, each one is going to be a buffer. And from here, I just need to tell Sharp where I want to be placing these on side of our, when it comes to our ticket. So for that, I can have overlays set up still in this try block. And for each overlay, I'm going to have the QR code overlay, the barcode, and then the SVG, which is the customer's text. Notice that top and left field are going to be where I'm placing them on the ticket template. But this is going to be different likely in your projects because I ended up going to Figma, and inside of here using my ruler, I could dictate myself where I wanted them. If you want them somewhere different, you can do that. You just have to find those positions yourself. But the very last thing that we have to do is once we have the positions in place, actually put them on the ticket. Nothing too crazy going on. We're just going to use the Sharp library to say, hey, template ticket, I want to compose the name of the customer and the QR code. Now I have one of these is likely going to be commented out, right? You don't want to display both a barcode and a QR code. Maybe you do, but I'm going to comment them out and then I'm going to stick them on the output path, which is going to be this holiday walkthrough. And then hopefully inside of here. So when it comes down to using it, you can go ahead and create however you want to use it, but I'm going to do something like this where the customer name is going to be my name right here. And then I'm going to lowercase and hyphenate it. This is what ends up showing up on the barcode or QR code. This is going to be that value. And then the location is going to be that hyphenated value. And then, sorry, the ID is actually going to be this some random ticket ID. Cool. What it looks like when I run it is I can say, hey, node index.mjs. And when I run that, we get ticket created, sure enough. And then if I come over here, you can see that the image name, if I can move this over, focus auto ticket.png. Great. And sure enough, we have our template with a QR code and then with focus auto on it. Now you can clearly expand this to have maybe like a CSV, read this data, and then just create a bunch of tickets on the fly after a customer has paid you money. But this is a really simple and fast example of how you can use Sharp, composing an image, and putting those all together from SVGs to buffers. Pretty freaking cool.